In this video, we'll be proving Bissig's theorem, which puts an upper and lower bound on the number of colors needed to edge color a graph. An edge coloring is valid if no vertex contains edges of the same color. For example, this is a valid edge coloring, while this is not. The theorem states that the number of colors chi prime needed to edge color a graph is between the maximum degree of the graph delta g and the maximum degree of the graph plus 1. As a reminder, the degree of a vertex is the number of edges containing it, and the maximum degree of the graph is the maximum degree of its vertices. Let's look at an example graph. We can use three colors to color its edges, which also happens to be its maximum degree. However, adding additional two edges like so doesn't change the maximum degree, but increases the number of colors needed by 1. Proving the lower bound is simple. Looking at a vertex with degree delta g, we obviously need as many colors as the number of its edges. Before proving the upper bound, let's make a quick observation that will be useful during the proof. When we have delta g plus 1 colors, each vertex of the graph has at least one free color. By free, we mean that the vertex doesn't have an edge of this color. This makes sense, because we have one more color than the maximum degree of the graph. Additionally, if an adjacent vertex also has this free color, they can switch the free color and the color of the edge between them without breaking the coloring. We'll prove the upper bound constructively. Let's assume that we have some partial coloring of g using delta g plus 1 colors, and want to color some edge xy. From the previous observation, we know that x has some free color. If y has the same free color, then we can color the edge xy using it. If x doesn't have this free color, then there must be an edge with this color from x to some other vertex, which also has some free color. This chain can go on quite a bit, but eventually, one of two things will happen. Case 1 is that the free color of the last vertex in the chain is the free color of x. In this case, we'll go back the chain and change colors. This frees up the color for x that we needed to color xy, and we're done. Case 2 is that the free color of the last vertex is a color of an edge from x that we've seen before. This is unfortunate, since we're now stuck in a loop and can't use the previous trick. In this case, we'll take the longest path from V of alternating free colors of x and u, and switch the colors on this path. We're doing this to get rid of the loop. However, since this path can end up pretty much anywhere, we'll again have to consider two possibilities. The first is that the path ends in the vertex right before V, let's call it W. Notice that by switching, we reduce the problem to case 1, only with blue and red reversed. The second is that the path doesn't end in W. This is even better, since X and W now have the same color, and we again reduce the problem to case 1. It's also good to realize that the switch operation doesn't break the coloring, since we would then have a neat but invalid proof. For vertices other than the first and the last, nothing happens, since they still have the edges of the same colors. For X, the free color was red to begin with, so it just turns blue. For the ending vertex, we'll make the observation that either red or blue must have been free, because otherwise the path that we took wasn't the longest. Combining the lower and upper bound, we see that no matter what, we can always color any graph using either delta g or delta g plus 1 colors.